Dear students, welcome to the part 5 of your module 2, Multiple Random Variables. Today, we shall study about rotational transformation and bivariate Gaussian distribution. In the last part, we studied about the basic concepts of your bivariate distribution as well as the correlation, covariance, correlation coefficient, etc. And also we studied about two variable transformations. Okay. So before going to the rotational transformation, let us review these formulae which you have studied. Correlation formula, expectation of x into y. Covariance is correlation minus mu x into mu y. And if this covariance is 0, in that case expectation of xy becomes mu x into mu y, and it is called as uncorrelated random variables x and y. And if expectation is 0, then your covariance becomes minus mu x into mu y, and we say that x and y are orthogonal. And if x and y are independent, expectation of xy is equal to expectation of x into expectation of y. That means covariance becomes 0. These two are equal means this becomes 0. And correlation coefficient is given by rho xy, or you can just write rho, which is covariance divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. Okay. So we are using these formulae throughout this module, so I am just giving this again. And in the last part, we studied about two variable transformations. If you have u and v, which are given in terms of the linear relationship between in terms of x and y. Ax plus by, which is u, and v equal to cx plus dy. Now, in this case, how to find the mean of u, mean of v, variance of u, variance of v, and covariance of uv. We studied this formulae, and also we worked out some problems using this formulae. So just recall this formulae once again. Okay. So remember this formula. Today we shall study about rotational transformation. Now if u and v have the coefficients, just like your previous transformation, u equal to ax plus by, v equal to cx plus dy. Okay, same type of transformation here, but you have the transformation through an angle theta. So here u equal to ax plus by, it is in that form, but a will be cos theta here, b is minus sin theta, and v is sin theta, v equal to cx plus dy, c is sin theta, and d is cos theta. So in this case, when you write this relationship in matrix form, you get u, v, the column matrix u, v equal to only the coefficient matrix, matrix of the coefficients of x and y. It is nothing but matrix with the cos theta, minus sin theta, sin theta, cos theta. And which are the variables here? X and y. It is taken as a single column. You can multiply and check this. When you multiply this matrix with this matrix and equate the corresponding entries, you get these two equations. Okay. So this is the matrix form of the given transformation. Now what is the inverse transform of this? That means how to write x and y in terms of u and v. For that, you have to check whether inverse for this matrix exists. So find the inverse of this matrix. You can write the inverse transformation in this form. Cos theta minus sin theta cos theta inverse. That means inverse of the coefficient matrix and uv. When you find the inverse of this, you get this answer. You just check it. You know how to find the inverse. How to find inverse of any matrix? We write adjoint of the matrix divided by the determinant of the matrix. Determinant of the matrix is clearly cos square theta plus sin square theta. And adjoint of the matrix is this. Check it. Into uv. Column matrix uv. When you expand this, clearly this denominator becomes 1. When you expand this, you get x equal to cos theta into u plus sin theta into v. First equation. And second equation, y equal to minus sin theta into u plus cos theta into v. I think all of you know how to multiply two matrices. Here we take the entries row wise and here we take the entries column wise. So when you multiply the corresponding entries, you get these two equations. So actually u and v are given in terms of x and y, but using inverse transformation, we have written x and y in terms of u and v. Now, how to find the mean of x and y using this transformation? Okay, mean of x and y. If mean of u and mean of v are given, how to find mean of x and y? It is given by mu x equal to cos theta into mu u. Check your equations once again. It is just linearity property. Okay, expectation of this equal to expectation of cos theta into u plus sin theta into v. But cos theta is a constant, you can keep outside. So remaining is cos theta into expectation of u plus sin theta into expectation of v. Okay, we are just using the linearity property here. Similarly, expectation of y, mu y, is given by minus sin theta into mu u plus cos theta into mu v. How to find the variance of xy and covariance of xy? Okay, just recall the formula for the two variable transformation. If this is in the form au plus bv and this is in the form cu plus dv, how to find the variance of x? We write a square into variance of u plus b square into variance of v plus 2ab into covariance of uv. Okay, recall the formula. So I am giving that your aim is cos theta. So cos square theta into variance of u, sigma square u, plus sin square theta into variance of v, plus 2ab into covariance of uv. 2 sin theta cos theta into covariance of uv. Same method is used for second equation. If you are using the second equation in the form cu plus dv, then what is the variance of y? It is given by c square into variance of u plus d square into variance of v plus 2ab into variance of covariance of uv. Anyway, here c is minus sin theta, d is cos theta. So when you square it, you get sin square theta into variance of u minus 2 sin theta cos theta into covariance of uv plus, you can write these three terms in any order. Either you can write it as a square plus b square plus 2ab or a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay, in any form, you can write these terms. And what is the covariance formula? Recall the formula. We are writing a into c. We are multiplying u terms. That means a into c. Then a into c variance of u plus b into d variance of v. Then this into this, that means a into d plus b into d covariance of uv. So using that formula, you get this sin theta into cos theta sigma square v minus sin theta into cos theta sigma square u. I have combined these two terms. Then covariance of uv term, okay, ad plus bc term, that is cos square theta minus sin square theta into covariance of uv. And if you use the formula for sin theta, cos theta and cos square theta minus sin square theta now, what is sin 2 theta formula? 2 sin theta cos theta. So this can be written as sin 2 theta whole divided by 2. And this can be written as cos 2 theta. Recall the formula. Cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. So using that, we can write sin theta cos theta into sigma square v minus sigma square u plus cos square theta minus sin square theta into covariance of uv. And what was your left hand side here? Left hand side was covariance of xy. Now covariance of x and y is given to you. That means if they give the condition that x and y are uncorrelated. If other terms are given to you, mu u is given, mean of u, mean of v, variance of u, variance of v and covariance of uv. If these terms are known and if they give the condition, find the variables u and v such that covariance of xy is 0. If they give this condition uncorrelated, random variables. Then this left hand side is taken as 0. And this is written as sine 2 theta by 2. This term is written as cos 2 theta. Simplify this. Rearrange the terms. When you rearrange these terms, you get, if you divide by cos 2 theta on both sides, this becomes tan 2 theta, and this term becomes only covariance of UV. Rearrange further to get only expression for tan 2 theta or theta. If you rearrange this further, you get this expression. Covariance of UV equal to minus tan 2 theta divided by 2 into sigma square V minus sigma square U. Just verify again. This is equal to, shifting this to left side, you get minus tan 2 theta divided by 2 sigma square V minus sigma square U. Again, rearrange. Tan 2 theta gives you 2 into cos UV with negative sign. Minus 2 into cos UV divided by sigma square V minus sigma square U. Okay, so either remember this formula, or equivalently, by removing this negative sign, I have written tan 2 theta equal to 2 into covariance of UV divided by sigma square U minus sigma square V. I think you understood the step how to remove this negative sign. This denominator is written as, instead of A minus B, it is written as B minus A. So negative sign is cancelled here. So remember, angle of rotation is given by tan 2 theta equal to 2 covariance of UV divided by sigma square U minus sigma square V. Now let us work out one problem. For the transformation, U equal to cos theta into x minus sin theta into y, and V equal to sin theta into x plus cos theta into y. So transformation U and V are given. The correlated bivariate random variables U and V are such that mu U and mu V equal to 0, sigma square U equal to 1, sigma square V equal to 7, and rho UV, rho means correlation coefficient, rho UV equal to minus 0.3. Find mean and variance of uncorrelated X and Y. Okay. So, first using the rho UV and this sigma UV, sigma U and sigma V, you can find the covariance of UV. You have the relation. Rho UV is given by covariance divided by sigma U into sigma V. So use that formula, rearrange the terms. You will get covariance of UV equal to rho into sigma U into sigma V. Substitute, rho is given minus 0.3. Sigma U is square root of the sigma square U. Square root of the variance. That means anyway it is 1. And square root of sigma square V, that is sigma V, square root of 7. Calculate this, it gives you minus 0.7937. Once if you know the value of covariance, you can directly find the angle theta using this formula. Tan 2 theta is given by 2 into covariance of UV divided by sigma square U minus sigma square V. Substitute the values, all values are known, substitute, you get 0.2645. That means 2 theta is tan inverse of 0.2645, which is 14.8190. And find the value of theta, half of this angle, which gives you 7.4095. Or you may get some nearest answer. It depends on the number of decimal places which you are selecting. Okay. And hence, theta is 7.4095. For this angle, x and y are uncorrelated. So for which angle theta, x and y are uncorrelated? For this angle, these are uncorrelated. And what is the question? Find the mean and variance of this uncorrelated x and y. So you need to find mean and variance of x and y. What is the inverse transformation? Remember it. Either you remember the theory part once again, from the theory part derive these formulae. Otherwise remember these two transformations. The inverse transformation is given by cos theta x equal to cos theta into u plus sin theta into v and y equal to minus sin theta u plus cos theta v. So using this, these are in the form au plus bv and here cu plus dv. You can easily write the mean of x. Mean of x, mu x is given by cos theta into mu u plus sin theta into mu v. But in the question, mu u and mu v are given as 0. So substitute, you get the answer 0. Similarly, for mu y, minus sin theta into mu u plus cos theta into mu v. But mu u and mu v are 0, so this answer also becomes 0. How to find the variance of x and y? Remember the formula. Variance of x is given by if this is au plus bv. You have the formula a square into sigma square u plus b square into sigma square v plus 2ab into covariance of uv. Same formula we are using here. In the place of a you have cos theta and in the place of b you have sin theta. Expand this and theta value is known. Using that theta value and substituting here, covariance of uv is obtained already. Substitute, you get 0.8968. Similarly, you can find using this transformation y equal to, you can find the variance of y. Use the same similar formula. Here one constant term is negative, c u plus dv, c is negative, remember it. So c square becomes sin square theta into sigma square u plus d square. D square is cos square theta into sigma square v and 2cd, that becomes 2 into minus sin theta into cos theta. You get minus sign here. Substitute every term and calculate. I have not shown the calculation step here. I have written the answer directly. Just verify. 7.1032. One more problem I am giving you just for your practice. It is required to have correlated bivariate random variables u and v such that mu u equal to 0, mu v equal to 0, sigma square u equal to 7, sigma square v equal to 20 and rho u v equal to 0.50. Specify uncorrelated random variables x and y and an angle theta that when used in the transformation will produce the desired u and v. Okay, here transformation is given. Even otherwise, even if this transformation is not given, uncorrelated x and y with angle theta means we always take this as the transformation. So remember this transformation. Transformation from uv to xy as well as x inverse transformation from xy to uv. Remember the transformation. So here they asked you to specify the random variables x and y. Okay, specifying the random variables means we are finding the corresponding terms, mean of x and y and variance of x and y, also angle theta. Same procedure which you have used in the previous problem. Just for your practice, I have included this problem. So I am not explaining much. Starting from rho uv, first to find covariance. You get this answer. Then start from the formula for angle theta. Tan 2 theta is this, substitute, find tan inverse of this, anyway you are using the calculator, just calculate and verify. You get theta equal to minus 21.1537. This is in degrees, okay. So cos theta, once if you know the value of theta, you can find cos theta and sin theta, okay. Or later, here you just keep theta as it is, later when these terms are required, you can calculate. Now what is the inverse transformation? Inverse transformation is given by x equal to cos theta u plus sin theta v and y equal to minus sin theta u plus cos theta v. Mean values of x and y are given by mu x and mu y. These mean values are in terms of mean values of u and v. Clearly values are 0. Variance of x and y are given by, use the formula and calculate. I am not explaining much because already we worked out one problem. Okay, I think you understood the method. Now let us go to the topic two Gaussian random variables. Now bivariate normalized Gaussian random variable is extended form of normalized single Gaussian random variable, which you studied in module 1. Okay, it is extended to bivariate case. Remember, what is the PDF of Gaussian random variable and PDF of normalized Gaussian random variable? Recall the PDFs once again. What is the PDF of normalized Gaussian random variable? You have 1 by square root of 2 pi into e to the power minus z square by 2. And how to convert from general Gaussian variable to normalized Gaussian random variable? We use a substitution, z equal to x minus mu by sigma. Remember, we already worked out some problems using that. Remember the standard transformation, z equal to x minus mu by sigma. It changes your Gaussian random variable into normalized Gaussian random variable. And what is the difference between Gaussian variable and normalized Gaussian variable? In Gaussian variable, mean is mu and standard deviation is sigma. In normalized Gaussian random variable, mean is 0 and standard deviation sigma is 1. Okay, so recall all the formulae, PDF and also the characteristic function, mean, variance, etc. Now, if you have two bivariate random variables, okay, with outcomes anywhere in the z1, z2 plane, I am taking two variables as z1 and z2. You can also make use of x and y, but here I am using normalized variables. Okay, so then normalized Gaussian bivariate. So in the case of normalized Gaussian variable, usually we use the notation z instead of x and y. Recall, we have taken z equal to x minus mu by sigma in the first module. Okay, so here both z1 and z2 are varying from minus infinity to infinity. In that case, the bivariate normalized Gaussian random variable has the PDF given by this. So this formula you have to remember. Okay, we are not deriving this fz1 z2 of z1 comma z2. It is just like fxy of x comma y. We have the variables z1 and z2 here. Formula is given by 1 divided by 2 pi into square root of 1 minus rho z square into e to the power. Actually, instead of e to the power, I am using exp of function, exponential function. Exp of minus z1 square minus 2 rho z z1 z2 plus z2 square into 1 by 2 into 1 minus rho z square. Okay. And in this term, z1 and z2 are known. They are random variables. And what is this rho z? Rho z is actually correlation coefficient between z1 and z2. Okay, using that only we are writing this PDF. Correlation coefficient between z1 and z2. You can also use the notation rho suffix z1 z2. I am just writing rho z here. Rho z is the correlation coefficient between z1 and z2. And you know the property of correlation coefficient. Always modulus of the correlation coefficient is less than 1. And clearly this term, when this is less than 1, clearly 1 minus rho z square will be greater than or equal to greater than 0, square root value. This will be greater than 0. So remember this bivariate PDF of Gaussian, normalized Gaussian random variable. Now how to find the individual PDFs of Z1 and Z2 using this bivariate PDF? It is the same method which you studied. How to find the marginal density with respect to Z1? For that, we integrate the bivariate PDF with respect to the other variable Z2. That means we eliminate Z2 to get a function of only Z1. Okay, I am not showing that step here. When you substitute for FZ1, Z2, that means bivariate PDF, which is your fz1 z2, this expression. Okay, and you need some adjustment steps. First you have to complete the square here. That for completion of square you may have to add and subtract some extra terms, adjustment. Then use some substitution as we have done in the case of a single variable. We used the substitution x minus mu by sigma equal to z. Okay, similar substitution step is also required here. So using all those steps, we can show that integration of this with respect to z2 gives you 1 by square root of 2 pi e raised to minus z1 square by 2. So you can see that this is nothing but the PDF of single normalized Gaussian random variable. Just remember the PDF. This is nothing but PDF of single normalized Gaussian random variable. Same method can be used to find the marginal PDF of for z2, fz2 of z2. It is given by integrating your bivariate PDF with respect to the other variable. So we eliminate this z1 after integrating, we substitute for z1. That means z1 is eliminated. Resulting function contains only z2. Again, same procedure, you need to square and then substitute, use some substitution step. I am not showing here. When you evaluate this, you will get 1 by square root of 2 pi e raised to minus z2 square by 2, where z2 varies from minus infinity to infinity. So clearly this is nothing but the PDF of single random variable z2, which is normalized Gaussian variable. Now if you evaluate this double integral, recall the property. What is the property of your bivariate PDF? The total volume under this surface. In the case of two variable case, this represents a surface. So total volume under this surface is equal to 1. Okay, that also you can prove. I am not showing the proof here. Just check it. And this total volume is same as the area under the single PDF. Similarly, area under the second PDF. So this is area and this is volume. All the three terms are equal to 1. Hence, fz1, z2 of z1, z2 is a PDF. So remember, for any function to be a PDF, we have two conditions. First condition, that PDF should be greater than or equal to 0. And second condition, integration of that PDF should be equal to 1. So remember this. So using the bivariate Gaussian normalized PDF, we can obtain the marginal PDF of each random variable. And these marginal PDFs are nothing but single variable Gaussian PDFs, normalized Gaussian PDFs. So just remember these methods. How to find the mean of Gaussian random variables z1 and z2? Mean of z1 is equal to mean of z2, which is nothing but mean of z. Okay, z is nothing but here bivariate random variable combined form z1 and z2. I am using z here, only one notation. Okay, so it is expectation of z1, z2. Z1, z2. Okay, this is the mean mu z, which is equal to 0. Similarly, variance of z1 and variance of z2 are equal to variance of only z, single random variable, which is equal to 1. Correlation of Gaussian random variables z1 and z2 is given by expectation of z1, z2 equal to, you have the formula for correlation. Expectation of product z1 and z2. Use that definition and you have to evaluate this. Even here also I am not giving you the evaluation step. This reduces to rho z, which is the notation used in your bivariate Gaussian normalized random variable. So remember, this rho z is already used in our definition of fz1, z2 of z1, z2. So you get the same answer, rho z here. So correlation of Gaussian random variables is used in your PDF definition. Now, remember one point. For normalized Gaussian random variable, z1 and z2, the correlation coefficient and covariance all are equal. All the terms are equal to rho z. Remember this point. When we work out the problems using this, expectation of z1 z2 is also taken as rho z. Covariance of z1 z2 is also taken as rho z. What is the reason behind that? Because your mean values are zero. Now, independence and uncorrelated Gaussian random variables. So when you say that two variables are uncorrelated, their covariance is zero. So here, if you consider two Gaussian random variables z1 and z2, which are uncorrelated, that means their covariance is zero. Covariance is zero means correlation coefficient is also zero. Rho z is zero. Okay. In that case, when you substitute this rho z equal to zero in the PDF of bivariate Gaussian random variable. Okay, this is the PDF. Once again, remember this formula. In that, here if you take rho z equal to 0, this full term becomes 0, and in the denominator this term becomes 0, you get only 1 by 2. This term becomes only 1 by 2. And this here you get only minus sign outside with the z1 square plus z2 square inside the bracket. And these are nothing but e to the power minus of z1 square plus z2 square divided by 2. 2 is common term for both. It is in the form e to the power a plus b. You can split and write it as e to the power a into e to the power b. So when you split and write this, e to the power a means e to the power minus z1 square by 2, one term, and e to the power b means e to the power minus z2 square by 2. So I have written two exponential functions separately here. And this term also becomes 1 because of your rho z answer. Rho z is 0. This 1 by 2 pi is written as product of two terms, 1 by root 2 pi into 1 by root 2 pi. Okay. Why we are writing this? This is nothing but PDF of the single random variable z1, and this is nothing but PDF of the single random variable z2. So it is clear that if z1 and z2 are uncorrelated, then their covariance is zero, and in that case bivariate PDF is nothing but product of two individual PDFs. And when you have this type of condition, you already studied under which type of problems you get bivariate PDF equal to product of individual PDFs. That is only in the case of independent random variables. So if you start from the result uncorrelated, we are getting the independence between the random variables. So we say that if bivariate Gaussian random variables are uncorrelated, then they are also independent. A standard result. Okay, they may ask you the proof. Prove that if bivariate Gaussian random variables are uncorrelated, then they are independent. This may be given in the form of a problem. So very simple, but you have to remember this PDF. So write in a sheet all the PDFs which are important and go through it. In the next session, we shall study about sum of independent random variables. And when the random variables are independent, how to find the PDF of their sum. Okay, a very important method we shall study in the next session. I'll stop here today. Thank you.